yesterday. This is gorgeous.
Yeah, yeah. That's true.
What's that?
Yeah, where's Paige?
I can drive. And then she was like all over the town.
I was night last night.
Oh my god.
She exaggerated.
Good god.
She likes it rough.
I'm going to turn you guys on the ends a little bit more into the middle. Yep, you're going to, right there, great. Okay. All right, guys.
Pouring the pot?
Ice water is cold.
Can't tell you where there was a green straw.
No. Everything done now? How come you got quiet when I put the camera on?
Get a little bit shy. Right. I was nervous, but I'm not anymore.
Cheers.
Let's stay together, yeah. Let them be masters of the fish of the sea, the birds of heaven, the cattle, all wild beasts, and all the reptiles that crawl upon the earth. God created man in the image of himself. In the image of God, he created him. Male and female, he created them. God blessed them, saying to them, be fruitful, multiply, fill the earth, and conquer it. Be masters of the fish of the sea, the birds of heaven, and all living animals on the earth. God saw all he had made, and indeed it was very good. This is the word of the Lord. The responsorial psalm is, the earth is full of the goodness of the Lord. Happy the nation whose God is Yahweh, the people he has chosen for his heritage. But see how the eye of Yahweh is on those who fear him, on those who rely on his love. Our soul awaits Yahweh. He is our help and shield. Our hearts rejoice in him. We must trust in his holy name. Yahweh, let your love rest on us, as our hope has rested in you. The second reading is a reading from the letter of Paul to the Ephesians. Follow Christ by loving as he has loved you. Husbands should love their wives just as Christ loved the church and sacrificed himself for her to make her holy. He made her clean by washing her in water with a form of words, so that when he took her to himself, she would be glorious, with no speck or wrinkle or anything like that, but holy and faultless. In the same way, husbands must love their wives as they love their own bodies. For a man to love his wife is for him to love himself. A man never hates his own body, but he feeds it and looks after it, and that is the way Christ treats the church, because it is his body and we are its living parts. For this reason, a man must leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two will become one body. This mystery has many implications, but I am saying it applies to Christ and the church. This is the word of the Lord.
To use their talents in such a way that whatever one is lacking, the other has to add to their life, to make up for, to enrich. And that's a lifelong process. They've known each other for quite a while. But they're, in the rest of their lives, things are going to happen that they never had discovered before, that are going to enrich their lives. And sometimes it's just going to be something very common, ordinary. The idea of being patient and kind with one another, sharing joys, sharing sorrows. And the love that they are patterning their life after is the love that Christ has for his church as we listen to the letter to the Ephesians. And we know that the love that Christ had for his church was a love that allowed him to sacrifice his life for the people that he loved. And so they come together willing to give whatever they need to help one another, to enrich one another's lives, to share with one another the fullness and the richness of life. And that just as Christ's love for the church is constant, that it helps everyone get through thick and thin, so the love that they have for each other does the same. It goes on forever, come what may. And finally, they tell us that their whole life is going to be based on the relationship that they have with one another. Matthew's gospel says that you have to love God and your neighbor. And love is a relationship, something that goes on day by day. Sometimes it's exciting. Sometimes it might even be boring. But it goes on and continues and gives them a rich and full life because they promised their life to each other. They promised to share their life in a way that is going to lead them to have friends, love their neighbor, and have God in their life. And one of the things that we celebrate too is the fact that God is in their life. That God's a necessary point of their part of their marriage. Because no human being is perfect enough to not have faults, to not need forgiveness. And so the forgiving love of Christ is a part of their life. And also the power of God's grace that allows them to overcome their weaknesses, to be patient, kind, and understanding with one another. They have a great love for each other. But the true strength that they have comes from their faith in Jesus Christ, which overcomes all the weaknesses that we have as human beings. It allows us to do things that other people cannot, because we depend not just on ourselves, but on the power of God in our lives. Mitch and Kristin, you have come together so that the Lord may seal and strengthen your love in the presence of this community. Christ abundantly blesses your heart. He has already consecrated you in baptism, and now he enriches and strengthens you by a special sacrament, so that you may assume the duties of marriage in mutual and lasting fidelity. And so, in the presence of all here, I ask you to state your intentions. Have you come here freely and without reservation to give yourselves to each other in marriage? Will you love and honor each other as man and wife for the rest of your lives? Since then, it is your intention to enter into marriage, join him, and declare your consent before God and his church.
Ave Maria.
that he would be with us. Mitch and Kristin have given their minds to each other very well. Let us pray. Please respond, Lord, your own prayer. For our world, keep the promise of peace, we pray to the Lord. For our hearts, keep the promise of loving each other, we pray to the Lord. For our hands, keep the promise of giving, we pray to the Lord. For our lives, keep the promise of growing, we pray to the Lord. For this couple, keep the promises of marriage and mutual and lasting fidelity, we pray to the Lord. Father, you have chosen us and given us your love, the power of the Spirit in our midst. Hear our prayer today and keep us open. May our faith issue forth in action and our love show itself in our lives. And our hope give us courage. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Thank you.
continue to go and bless you and your children. May the Holy Son of God have mercy on you and help you in good times and in bad. May the Holy Spirit of God always fill your hearts with his love. And may Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Let us go in peace to love.
Yeah. special day with me and Mitch. It's one of the happiest days of my life, and I'm sure Mitch's too. I'm going to introduce my sister, my maid of honor, and Mitch is gonna introduce someone else.
My brother, Sean. He's the best man. I want to thank everybody for coming too. All the people in back who can't hear what we're saying, thank you. Enjoy the food. I'll probably steal Sean's speech, but thank you to all my friends that drove a long ways. Who came from Texas or the East Coast, Sioux Falls, the cities. Means quite a bit to say you guys all came. And everybody from Dumont, thank you. Okay, Sean, you can go over now. Thank you.
He did steal my speech. That's exactly what I was going to sing. It's a good tribute to Mitch and Kristin. People driving from Texas, flying in from North Carolina, driving 10, 20 hours to be here. I think that's saying a lot about the type of people Mitch and Kristin are. And I just want to say that I know I would not be the person I am without Mitch. He's been my idol and been someone that I've looked up to and tried to emulate myself to be like him for years. I see what kind of effect Kristin has on him, and it's nothing but good. And I think that it's a beautiful day, it was a beautiful ceremony, and it's going to be a beautiful night.
All right. I've did my speech in a poem format. So here we go.
Loud. It was a magical year, 1982. I was blessed with a little sister, blonde hair and eyes of blue. I liked you and all, but I wanted someone to notice me, so I cut my hair and my blankie. As you grew up, you joined dance. Mom and Dad say you were the best butt shaker in the entire class. Christmas came the year you were three. You found a guitar and a horse you could ride under the tree. You liked that horse so much, as a matter of fact, that you only rode it after taking off your pants. A half-naked three-year-old on a horse with a guitar. If I hadn't known better, I'd have thought you were a country music star. As you got a little older, you became more and more naughty, spending all of your time playing Care Bears or My Little Pony with your imaginary friend, Jakey. Then along came our little brother, Eric, sweet as could be. Kristin wasn't too sure of him. Everything was about me, me, me. Kristin went on to school, making all kinds of friends. Little did she know, those friends would be with her until the end. My sister and me were stuck together many summers long. We'd play school, house, and Barbie so nice, it was hard to believe we got along. Then here came Eric with his Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. Our Ken and Barbie didn't stand a chance when Leonardo, Michelangelo, Donatello, and Raphael stole our Barbie convertible. School soon started, and we had to catch the bus. This was our means of transportation, so we couldn't put up a fuss. Kristin was a happy spirit, you see. She'd get on that bus, happy as could be. Then those Frisch boys, Mitch and Sean, would call her guy Smiley. The elementary days came and went so fast. Before I knew it, she was at my high school dance. Then the time came for Kristin to drive. Mom in the passenger seat, afraid for her life. Driving 101 on the gravel roads with Mom, a deer jumped out. Kristin let go of the wheel. She covered her eyes and let out a squeal. She was given a blue Escort from Mom and Dad. The car didn't stand a chance, dents it always had. Senior year came, she was crowned homecoming queen. This year was full of excitement, all unforeseen. The parties, the friends, all so much fun. Who knew she'd lose her favorite shoes in the mud while on the run? Graduation came and went, and so did her college days. She met Mitch, moved to Sioux Falls, and soon a baby was on the way. During those long 9 months, we had went for a visit. That's when we learned one of Mitch's secret tidbits. You see, after a couple beers, Mitch cut loose and told us, he and Taddy can do the sun-eye cackle like no one else's business. Went on, then April came. We knew to expect a baby boy. No one would be his name. Then on the 29th, we finally received the phone call. Eric was given the best birthday present of them all. A little boy named Nolan David is now in our lives for good. If you'd ever met him, it would be understood. His big blue eyes and cheeks so chubby, when he gets bigger, he's gonna be my buddy. As I watched Nolan grow week after week, there are so many words I tried to seek. I know I want to thank you, Kristin and Mitch, for giving us Nolan's life. Oh, what a gift. May a lifetime of love and happiness be in store for you. May all your days ahead be sunny, not blue. Best wishes and congratulations, you guys.
I want to say one more thing, too. I'm getting there. thank you, Mom and Dad, Jerry and Brenda, Nicole. I love my parents more than anything, my family, and my new family have been so great to me. I can't fish, I don't know nothing about cars, but they still like me. But Kristin put a lot of work into this, Kristin, Nicole, and Brenda. I didn't do a whole lot, but thank you all for coming. I mentioned Mom. I love you all for coming. Thank you very much, and have fun tonight.
Yeah. Thank you. guys have a huge influence on my life.
Let's get fucked up!
I love you!
Let's get fucked up!
Hey, Kristin, good luck. I wish you
it was a six letter word.
At the Legion, confident Gary Peterson. Congratulations, Mitch, Kristin. Love you guys. All right, let's party.
I can't believe this one.
Give the dance.
Well, say something.
Oh, I know you're videotaping. Hey, Mitch and Kristin. I'm not supposed to be in here. Gary's mad. I just want to wish you luck. You guys rock. Anytime you need to switch around, you know who to call.
Yes, I'm not done yet. There he says I'm not done. So, live long and prosper.
Mitch and Kristin, I love you guys. Best of luck. We'll always be together. We'll always know if they want to get together and everything like that. It's going to be great. Love you.
Congratulations, you guys. I've been telling people it is possible to polish a turd, as you saw me today. Thanks for making me look good. Thanks for inviting me to be in your wedding. It's a huge honor. Nolan, Nate, you guys, Nick and I, and Sioux Falls, I love having you guys down there, and I can't wait to have a lot more fun in the future. I wish you the very best. In a week, 8 days, I'm getting married. We're going to be in the same boat. So, again, congratulations, and best of luck to you guys.
Ready? Hey, Kristin and Mitch, it's Eric, new brother, and thanks for giving me my new brother. That's awesome. You guys are the best. I love you both. Good luck in the future, and overall, having a good time today. All right, thanks.
Hey, guys, congratulations. If I don't make it for gift opening, it's because I'm in Mexico on you guys.
Woo! I thought you were going to California.
Wedding bliss like your mom and I. Thank you.
experience talking to man. 4-3-0-5-1-1. This might take a couple minutes. 5-9-8. By the way, Mitch and Kristin, there was a 5-0-5. We got a winner. All right, 5-0-5. Guess what? All the fun and games are over now. It's just time to party and after see.
When I start making love, I don't just make love, I be stalking.
Say something nice.
Wish you a happy marriage. Good luck. That's it.
Time. Hope everything, yeah. Woo! No.
Good luck, many more years of happiness. Good luck to the price.
Good luck, Kristin. Mitch, you love you, Kristin.
You ready? Best wishes to the bride and groom. Many years of happiness. That's all. Next.
Good luck, Kristin and Mitch. Many, many years of happiness.
It's a lot better than my marriage. Just kidding.
Barbie, you troll. Hey, John.
No, I think Hank and Nancy are wonderful. They have a wonderful son, and I've known him for a long time. They'll have a great marriage and a great life, and I wish them all the best.
Tons of other ones. Just pray you don't have girls because they tend to get a little lippy at age 11. But, lots of love.
It's Kristin, buddy. Kristin, I love you. Kristin,